Hello, welcome back to Biology in a Box. Today we will learn with the black box. For this activity, we will utilize the scientific method. The scientific method can be broken down into 7 steps. First, we begin with a question. In science, there are many things we'd like to seek an answer to. This all begins with a question. Second, we do our research. To begin the task of finding an answer to our question, we have to know a little bit about our topic. This makes for an intelligent researcher. Next, we form a hypothesis. This is mostly referred to as an educated guess, but more accurately, this is a testable educated guess based on our best inputs. Next, we experiment. Our experiment will yield either supportive or rejective evidence of our hypothesis. Then we come up with a conclusion. This is a summary of our findings. Lastly, we communicate our findings. This can allow others to validate your results and even recreate your experiment. Now we will continue on to the black box experiment. First, you will divide into teams. Each team will get both a white box and a black box. You may also need a clear plastic container. Throughout the course of the experiment, no matter how tempted you are, do not open the black box. The white box, however, you can open. Your white box will have 11 different items inside. But if you don't have 11 different items, contact your teacher. One of the items in this white box is also in your black box. First, what you should do is examine the objects in your white box. And then think of other characteristics that may help you identify the mystery item in your black box without opening it. What about the sound the object makes when it hits the tin? Is it soft or loud? How about how heavy the object is compared to other objects? You can even take all of the items out of your white box except for one item to help you observe characteristics you may observe later in your black box. If you choose to do so, make sure to place all the items in your plastic container so they don't roll away. You will make a table listing the 11 objects and some characteristics for each of the items. The central focus of science is to test ideas. Because there are 11 different objects in our box, that means there are 11 different ideas or hypotheses we can test. Make a list of these 11 hypotheses using the form, "There is a blank in the black box." Beside each of these hypotheses, you can make a few notes of what you think you might observe in the black box if that object is inside. Use some of the characteristics from the table you made earlier. Then you will make predictions based on these hypotheses. For example, if there is a cotton ball in the black box will be very light and will not make a noise if it's shaken. Now let's put each of these hypotheses to the test. Based on your observations from the black box, you should be able to mark out several hypotheses that are incorrect due to their predictions not being met. This should eliminate several hypotheses. However, if you still have more than one hypothesis that is still supported by your test on the black box, re-examine all the items in the white box again. Try to think of some more characteristics that may help you narrow down your choices further. In the end, you will pick one hypothesis as a team that you think is the most unlikely, and you will prepare a statement including the evidence you found. You are still not allowed to open the black box. Now each team will tell the class their conclusion and how they came to that conclusion. Now you can open the black box. Did you get it right? Thank you for watching and learning with Biology in a Box's Black Box.